everyone. I'm going to try and do a rainbow painting today. One of my lovely subscribers suggested it. I've never done one before, but I'm quite looking forward to it. I've got a couple of thoughts on how I'm going to do it. I'm going to do a bit of a basic background, because obviously the rainbow should be the focal point. I've actually got my colours separated out, so I'm going to be doing quite a lot of mixing on the palette. So I will just take you through gently, but I hope you relax and enjoy, and I hope it turns out okay, but we'll enjoy doing it. Okay, let's crack on. So I've got burnt umber, ultramarine blue, yellow, cerulean blue, orange, white, and I'm going to use these as a base for the clouds and the mountains, and then I'll get the primary colours out to do the rainbow. So we'll need red, yellow and blue, and we'll make the variations from that. That's the plan anyway. So let's start with the sky. Start where we know. Take a bit of the phthalo blue. Sorry, that's the ultramarine, but phthalo blue. And a bit of the white. More some colour on to start. You'll notice this time I've got masking tape around the edge, because I wanted to be able to focus more on the actual painting as opposed to the sides. So I'm just getting some colour in for the sky and then water, because if I manage a successful rainbow, then we might want a reflection of it. Okay, bit of colour. add it into there a bit more. And I want the tiniest touch of the yellow. Just a suggestion. To make the cloud not 100% white. Try again. I'm going to have my rainbow here, so generally the weather might be worse that side, so lighter this side. Okay, but we still want clouds, so let's keep it moving, keep it rolling. And then I want slightly darker. I'm going to come back and highlight some of these the tops of the clouds in a bit once that's drier with pure white. So have a violet. So I'm going to just pop a little bit of that on the side. And take a little bit. Just mix it here. To get a darker. Interestingly, when you add orange, it actually makes it slightly more grey. Right, so let's come here. I think like a cloud. getting some more white. And I'm just going to highlight. I like that. I just want slightly darker. Just some areas of slightly darker under here, because this is our stormy side. I might come back and put some more white on the top when that's dry a little bit. Yeah, I think I will. Okay, so we have a background. Now, did I want rain? So let's make this here, bottom of the cloud. There. Just a suggestion of the rain coming down. They are. I will definitely need to the end of the world. No mistakes. Happy accidents. Okay. Right. So that's a nice little sky. I want to put in mountain. So for that, I'm going to take some of the burnt umber. The ultramarine and some white. Let's see what this looks like. I'm going to try for bluer is further back, brown is further forward. And I just want a vague outline. So that's quite good for further forward, but this needs to be bluer. Oh, it's picked up some of the purple. Not the end of the world. Okay. Want a touch darker. A smidge of black might not do any harm. There we go. Okay. Right. I need to pull that down again over the mountain. But anyway, let's pop in a mountain. Just kind of that sort of white. And pull it down. I'm not using an actual palette knife this time because I just want the mountain in the background. Clean brush. Just missed the bottom. Okay. I do want a little bit more rain coming down, I think. Carried away doing the mountain. Really doesn't matter if it's going to be covered up by the rainbow. So I don't know what I'm doing. Anyway, you get stuck and you spend ages doing this. It's nice, was the whole point, and enjoy and paint and play around. All those good things. Missed it up a bit. Right, now I might put some highlights on that in a bit once I've done the rainbow, but let's focus. So, I'm going to put the rainbow in now because then I think we can hide the base behind some trees and see if we can get some water in here. Now, first thing is I've got to clear a space. So we're thinking, where is it going to go? That's the bad side of the weather, this is the good side. So are we going to have it sort of here? Have it here, shall we? Okay. Finger clean. Arch and do quarter rainbow. So we're going to go sort of here. How's that? As much paint off. Okay. Now, playing around with different brushes today. It's too dark. Clean it. afford a brush cleaner. That's not very good. Not very good at all. I'm trying a different one. Right, and that's not clean. Gotta try a different one. Right. Start with the white base. The reason why I'm starting with a white base is because when you're adding the colours to it, it needs to be white, otherwise we're not going to get the right mix, because it'll pick up the purple and the grey. Like an arch. Right. There we are. Okay, so now I need some rainbow colours. Richard of York game Battle in Vain. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. So I need some red. I need to start another palette for this. Right, red. I haven't got red. I'm going to go for alizarin crimson and a touch of normal red, because alizarin crimson is a bit too, well, it's a lovely colour, but it's a bit too passionate almost. It's quite a fiery one. It's lovely, but man, just need a bit of normal red. Don't see many rainbows, don't bring it. So let's put a bit of red on. Don't need much. And then I'm just going to put a touch of brilliant red on the green. Let's go for light green, I think. Ooh, it's a bit fluorescent. It's too green. In that case, we'll go light green and add a bit of phthalo green, like I'm doing with the red. The alizarin crimson, trying to calm the red down a bit. See if I can do the same with the other yellow I already have. Do I need more white? No. Okay. So look, I've barely got anything on here because we won't need much. I say this is more of a mixing day really, isn't it? Lots of colours to mix. So, which brush am I going to use? I'm going to use a small one. But I won't mix it with that. I'll mix it with this. So, right, commit, Kate, commit. So I'm taking some white. I'm going to take a smidge of each. Is that red enough? Finger clean, I'll just blur this a bit. Why am I doing that? Take a clean brush. Do it. Okay. Richard of York game battle in vain. Red on the outside. Yeah, that's right. Okay. I'll try and not get my head in the way so you can see. But I've got to assume a stance so I can make an arch. Okay, right, commit. Too much. That's not red enough either. Too high up this way. Yeah. Okay. One. There we are. Fairly happy with that. Where did I put that brush? I think it needs to be a bit more red though. Do I have any more red? Red, orange. So I'm going to take, I could just do orange, but I might try and just make orange instead. touch my yellow. That's making it with the red I've just used and the yellow hip. Okay, in we go. Okay, but I've got to make sure I've got enough room for them all. Slightly. Okay. Richard of York, yellow. Straight into yellow. Oops. Might need to blend then a bit more. Richard of York gained. Green. Let's see what we can do with these two here. I'm not even cleaning the brush because it's all a spectrum, isn't it? It's quite... bit too yellow in it. Bit more yellow. What do we think of that? Yeah. Go for it. Getting a nice white washed arm. Might need to top this up afterwards. Okay, again, I'm trying to get my head out of the way. Blue. Got blue here. Oh, actually, oh, I can make the blue with the red. I'm going to do that like I did for the orange. Sorry, yellow. Yellow and blue make green, red and yellow make orange. Okay. So I've got my blue. Is that blue enough? It's not really. A bit more. Okay. It's my cat scratching the sofa in the background. She has a little tinker. Indigo and violet. I actually have a violet here, so I might cheat. Oh, got two. How pretty is that? Nice palette to work with. So indigo is slightly bluer. So I'll mix that with what I've just done here for this one. And then, ooh, blend. And then violet. Plain violet. Which actually isn't violet enough, so I'm just adding a smidge of red, just to differentiate a bit more from here. There we go. Let's move this, get this blended a bit. There. Not bad. I'm just going to do a little gentle bit of blending anyway. It's the right shape. That's it. Okay, and then I'm happy with those colours. They're nicely make sure that's okay up here. Tidy up this end of it. And interestingly, it will be lighter over here anyway, won't it? So I'm going to put a bit more white in here to help clean it up. Even put a teeny smidge of yellow. There we are. The light under the rainbow. Always nice when you like something you've created. Yeah, that's good. Good, good, good. Happy, happy, happy. Right, so I'm going to hide it in some trees, I guess. Does that need a bit more? The thing is with these, you can always tweak. You can just get a bit carried away and keep adding. I think that needs a little more here. Just a touch more definition on the top. I've also got to put a bit more whites on the clouds, remember? Sometimes I do these paintings and I quite often top up the next day just to sort of finish off any edges, or if it's a bit drier, because it's sometimes you can put mist on, it's easier to put mist on when the mountains are dry. You can put little clouds on and it's drier. Well, you can when it's wet, but... Right. Good. Right, I'm going to try and replicate that down here. Let's not worry about that for a minute. Let's put some trees in. What colour trees? Trees, trees, trees. Mind you, I am going to need... Yeah, while we've got these colours and I'm in the zone. What's this? Oh, that's that colour. I need a little bit of that, I guess. Put some of that in here. With a bit of the blue and some of the white. This can make our water. Just get the colour in. Oh, I muddled it with the black.
actually really care about this bit, so I'm going to hide it. The liquid white is drying a bit, I didn't put much on. No, I like that one too. Okay, obviously this is going to be much more filtered, less bright because it's in the water. Put some of that on. That right? Or is it more? Okay, well, let's crack on. Doesn't need to be as vibrant as the one on the top. Not at all. It's good that I kept all of these, so I can still just use them, which is rather good. And then the blue. And violet. Yeah. Okay. Just blend this way. So my hand caught it. Bit of contrast. Right, and then Use more blending. Blending is slightly less. Yeah, that's better. Because it's just a suggestion, isn't it? Okay, so blend, blend. Cool. Again, I think that red needs to be just a bit brighter, a bit more red. It's always nice to have red in a painting. Lovely, lovely. Right, let's get some trees in. Are we nearly done? What am I going to use? I'll take some of the burnt umber and my green. Right, so let's go. Commit. Don't know why I started there. The focal point. Oh, here we go. Light top, lovely, and remember find the line and pull, water line and pull, 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 straight down. Right, I've not joined that bit. So I need to make that a bigger tree. And I'm going to put a bit of waterline in, some of the white. In fact, I'm actually going to, make a bit of land colour with the burnt umber. Try to get in a little bit of land. That's sitting on, so that the trees aren't just floating. And I'll touch that up with a little bit of more burnt umber over the top, I think, and waterline in here. It and some more ripples and nice things like that. Let me pull some of the white out. Yeah, that's good. I think I might just put a little bush here just to set it back a bit. Where's my brown? This one's actually burnt sienna. I do want to tidy that waterline up at the back there. That's not quite right. I'm going to leave that alone because I'm meddling. She says meddling more. Okay. Am I happy with the water before I cover this up with a bit of a brush? And a bush. What colour bush? Let's mix up some of the browns and the greens that I've already got. Way too much. Problem is, when you use these massive pots, massive tubes, too much comes out at once. That bush like. Yeah, that'll do. I'm just going to put a bush here and here. I'm not going to do trees, just to sort of the rainbow into the background. And I shall highlight them after. There we go. Touch of yellow on the top, just to bring out some of the bits. And a bit darker in here. There we go. I am going to add more white at the top. Let me just do that quickly. Where's my white? I'm just going to turn it so you can see it a bit better. I'm pleased with that. In fact, I'm going to leave it. I'm going to wait until it's completely dry or drier, and then I'm just going to bring out some of these white bits just to highlight the tip of them a little bit more. Sometimes once it's dried it shows up a little bit brighter, but I think I'm quite pleased with it. I hope you've enjoyed. Yes, hope nice and relaxed. And if you fancy giving it a go, I think I've said all the colours I've used, but give it a whirl, why not? If you liked, please do click like and subscribe. Thank you for subscribing if you already have. It does make a difference. I think when I get to a certain number, then I can remove the adverts in the middle of the video, which would be really good, because I know they're very annoying, but I don't have the power at the moment. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. Have a lovely day, evening, wherever you are, and see you soon.